running, no gunshots, but they getting low, 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 low.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome to the first edition of Thursday Modding. This is kind of a little series I'm starting since I'll be doing modding / Giants Editor videos on Thursdays. So I just want to start this video. Sorry about whatever happened to yesterday's video, the ATS video. Evidently, OBS decided to be completely dumb and like freeze at the ATS loading screen. So when I bought a new truck, the whole thing, I was, you know, talking away about it and whatever, and you guys couldn't see it. So I'm going to show you some screenshots of that truck. And then in Sunday's ATS video, I will show you, I'll do an more in-depth, review or whatever of the truck. So let's go ahead and get started here. So here's the truck. It's a Peterbilt 379. We have a 63-inch sleeper tri-axle. We've got the hood mirrors. We got some old custom style mirrors there. Got the same visor that the old truck had. We got the 379 mirrors with the forward antennas. We got a diamond plated fender. We have diamond plated fenders, chrome fuel tank, chrome steps with lights on either side, some nice stacks. This grill guard, in Sunday's video, we'll be getting a different grill guard, one that will be full of lights. We have some shark teeth here that are painted the same color as the truck. It's kind of like a bluish color. Got a mesh grill. Some fender blocks or fender savers, whatever they are. All tires, rims, hubs, caps, everything's all the same all the way around. Once we get to a picture with the lights of the truck on, you'll see some neat stuff on the air cleaner and inside. Here's a rear view. We got the headache rack with a whole bunch of lights around that as well. Mud flaps, a neat bumper, and then we also have a diamond plated deck plate. Here's a somewhat picture with lights. I'll show you a better one. Here it is at night. You can see we got some neon blue lights in the air cleaner. And if you can see right there, you can see it's red inside. That's a neon red light inside. And then we got the bumper all lit up and the headache rack. So, had to stop and fill some fuel and then dropped off the trailer. So, yeah, that's what that is. This is my second attempt at making this video. I was going to do it on the main farmhouse for my map, but unfortunately it's wanting to be really, really dumb. So we're going to work on the Chandler 24 RDT tender. We're going to try and get this finished up here in Blender. Yeah, I don't know what the deal. The house, like, the encoding on my computer just went, like, super high whenever I was using that. So, I don't know what its deal was there, but. Okay, so, looks like I was doing what? Okay, so, top. Okay, so I want that on. Everything else can be off. Chassis, and then, okay, so what is this piece here? Okay, so that's not it. Oh, top, that's right, there's more pieces in top. I removed my cube, didn't I? Yes. Okay, what's all this stuff? So this is all the top part. Oh, yeah, okay. Alright, so now we have a little bit better of a view here to get this. I want this one. Actually, I want them both. So what I'm doing here is I am trying to make a dynamic fill plane for this. So that way, when it's in game and you fill it, you can actually watch it fill. So now, if we take this and pull it. Let's see, let's try and pull it straight even with this. There we go. Now we want the face select. I'll get all zoomed in here so we can see what we're doing. Then we want this again. Okay, that actually looks pretty good right there. So now let's do the same over on this side here. So yeah, the hard thing with this is trying to get everything lined up. Because you want everything to be kind of lined up, but you also don't want it to be like, you know, too off or anything. You don't want it to be really messed up. It's kind of a tricky thing to do. This is my first time ever doing a dynamic plane as well, so, and that also plays into things. Okay. So now if we go into object mode, how's that look? Pretty good, except for this thing here. I wonder if it would have actually worked better. I wonder if it would have worked better just to... No, maybe not. I want the line. I guess I just want this one, huh? Let's see if I can dissolve those. What's that do? No, I cannot dissolve edges. Negatory. Dissolve faces. No. Okay, so... How can I do this? Okay, so now what's going to happen if I dissolve these? Let's turn that visibility off for a second. Dissolve edges. Okay, good. So that didn't do much of anything at all. Okay, so now if we bring that back up. So now comes the fun part. Trying to... Oh, actually, I'm not going to make this go all the way up there. I think that actually turned out pretty well. We do have a few spots here that I can see that need to be touched up just a little. Oh, crap. Oh, it's not even what I wanted to do. Okay, I want to get it on this side here. Nope. Not going to let me, is it? Okay, well, let's see. Let's go. Okay, we're in face. So let's just kind of suck these in a little bit. Or this one at least. Suck it in to about the point. And we gotta do this one just a little bit. And then this rear one as well. Okay, so now I gotta try and position this piece. I have no idea how I'm going to do this. Okay. So now if I do that and turn it wrong direction. Wrong direction again. Turn it just like that. It should be in the keyword, all line up over here. With some fine tuning, it should. That looks pretty dang good. That looks actually perfect. Sweet. So if we join these, dynamic is what we'll call that. Okay, so now to find a trailer. Meridian max 14, I think that's what I want. Now I just need to find a trailer. No, that is not it. Seed Express, there we go. Just need to get this trailer that has dynamic fill plane as well, and kind of look at how everything is set up here. Both in Giants Editor and in the XML. So we got 1260. Fill volume shape is what it is called. Okay, so we're going to copy that. Does this have a material on it? Yes, it does, but it does not have. Okay. Okay, so we'll do that, and then new. Fill. Now we'll export that as an i3d. Call that dynamic. That did not export, did it? No. Why? Okay, let's try as an FBX then. Dynamic. Okay, so that exported. Import dynamic, and that should fit right into place of where it needs to be. And it does accept. Shoot. I forgot to remove the setting, or I forgot to check export selected only. Selected objects, there we go. Now it'll export and import a whole lot faster because I'm not trying to import and export the whole entire model. So we'll put that there. Yes, I'm still recording. Good. So now we just have the visibility on in that. So then just non-renderable. Okay, so we don't have the ridge body on. Okay, so now that's set up like that. Okay, so we need the exact fill root node. Well, yeah. So, where is the... So that's the unload trigger, trailer trigger, unload trigger. So I need that. That. Fill auto aim? I have no idea what that does. Transform. I thought there'd be a trigger out here somewhere too. But I guess not. So we need this and this. Export those. Express parts. Okay, so we can close that. Now we'll import express parts. Exact fill root node. Okay, so let's just put this on static here for a moment. So that way I can maybe... Yes, I can change it. Okay. So let's see. The width is okay. Oh, wrong one. Wrong one again. 0.8 maybe. Let's go 7.5. Well, actually, we... Yeah. Because this is the exact length of that, so let's go 7.7 maybe. So we're good on that end and good on that end. Cool. So I'll take this and put it up there as well. So now this had that going straight out the back, just like that. And so then it was at the rear of this. Perfect. Create a transform group, because that's needed for spawning in. Okay, so now we need to put this back on kinematic. Freezing the scale. So that way those are all set to 1. Okay, now I think that's all that we need off of here. Tarp, joint, light coronas. I'm not worried about those at the second. I just want to get this thing in-gamed and working first. Alright, my wonderful OBS decided to stop again and completely screw up. So what I just have done is I've added in the jacks, or the collisions on the jacks, rescaled those, and now I'm just working on all of this stuff. So we got the mod desk all changed, NAFEM, Polygonish, Craft Farms Modding, Chandler 24 RDT in there. That's Chandler, Chandler, Store, Brand, KFM. Need to get rid of that M there. Seeds and fertilizer, capacity I'm not changing, price and daily upkeep I'm not changing yet. Auger wagons is the category it will stay in. Got this stuff changed, and now all the wheels are indexed. So light coronas, those I'm not going to change yet. That stuff not changing. Fill volume. Okay, so fill volume 011. Okay, so that's that. So we need 04. Unload info is 013. So, oh, we need that. I suppose that's right where that goes, huh? So if I put that like right at the back. So I guess I need that fill auto aim too. Yes, I do. Well, we'll get to that. So fill volume unload info. So let's import that. Nope. Import. So that one I had at the back of the trailer, so that's where I'm going to put this one, I guess. Just because I don't exactly know what it's for. So I'm going to have to keep checking this because I don't know why, but it likes to stop. Okay, so that index is 08. Fill volume discharge info 04. Holy crap, there's a long line there. So we need 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. Okay, there's how many zeros in that? 2 zeros, so we need 1, 1. Oh, the discharge particles. That would kind of be helpful. Let's see, I'm going to need all of that, aren't I? Discharge info. Oops. So we can get rid of all that stuff. Overloading capacity 600. Okay. So this piece here. Okay, I'm just going to export that entire piece, this entire node thing. Spout. Okay. File, export selection, node. So we can just bring all that stuff out. Import node, and that can go under the auger as well here. Oofta. Where? What in the world? So we're just going to set all this stuff to zero. Maybe. We'll just zero all this out. Just get everything straight here. 21, 22. Okay. So now let's just get all this stuff lined up here. Okay, so that's perfect right there. Except this has to be turned as well. No, it doesn't. Okay, so the node for this is 0, 1. Okay, so we need the discharge, correct? Discharge info, yes. Fill root node is 0. Okay, it can go to that too, I guess. Exact fill root node. So that is this guy, which is 05. Fill. Okay, so 014. So that's the one before. So we do need this. Export selection. Fill auto aim. Okay, and then we can import that. And we'll put that in the center of this. Okay. And that is 09. Fill mass node, that's 0 there. Unload trigger, 06. 060. So ours is 060. Okay, so that we don't need to change. Trailer trigger, that we don't need to change. Input attacher joints. Do I have an attacher joint? We have an attacher joint there. Do we have one here? No. File, export selection, attacher. So this is the piece that takes the most amount of tuning, because you gotta get it just right. Can't have it too far up, too far down, too far one direction, otherwise you just get all messed up. And I'm just gonna kinda look at this guy for reference here. Ooh, that's way up at the top. Not one, okay. So we'll put it right about there for now and then adjust it later on. 0, 10. So animated parts we don't need. Mouse control, don't need. Moving tools, moving parts. Okay, is there anything that's referenced to 0, 11? Because if there is there, then okay, no, there is not. So we don't need any of that. We don't need animations, I don't believe. No, we don't. Pipe. That I might want to need, might want to leave. Yes. Node is 0, 5 on that. Hey. What's this for exactly? 0, 5. Huh. So now this wants one, so this wants two, so raycast. So that is auger node. So that is that thing there. I guess we can export empty here. Empty. Save. Still recording good. So I'll put that in the exact same spot as this, which is 0. So this is 0, 11. So we want this to be 0.02, this to be 0.5, and then negative 2. I don't know if I want it like that. Where is the empty transform group? I don't think they have one. Okay, anyway, we'll just go with that, I guess, and see what happens. I did turn... Oh, I gotta remember to turn rigid bodies off of everything. Otherwise, we will have some major issues. Okay, so we have 4, 0. Wait, what? 4, 0, 0, 1, 0. Particle systems. So auger node particle systems. We'll control shift alt and just do both of those at the same time. Those I don't believe I need to change. I'll find out, I guess. So we don't need these. Dirt duration, I like to have that at 30. We only need 4 wheels. Okay, so now let's mess with some lights. See view. I want it to show my lights. I guess it's not going to show these. So we have that, that. So we just need two of these. Well, okay, let's just export all of these here. File, export with files. Lights. Oops, wrong one. Import lights. Let there be lights. Okay, so these, boy, how did, so light corona, turn signal, light corona. So let's move the turn signals up. So we only need two of these. Anyway, let's get these brought out here. Let's get them positioned where they're supposed to be. Oh, we do actually have some lights over here. Okay, I have to look at those though. Let's look at the Chandler model here. See if those are actual, if those indeed are actual lights. Solid. So this is the original one here. Yes, so the top one, oh, we do have a light there too. So that's a turn signal, that's a turn signal, and that's a turn signal. That, that, and that. What? Wrong button. Okay, so unload info, node, light, set, that, those can all go up there. So let's see, we got that centered there. So we can take that, copy it, and go like this, and put that to positive. Perfect. Okay, so now I wonder, yeah, I shouldn't have done that. There we go. So we'll take this one and slide them over just a little bit. So then we'll go back left, that, and then positive on that. And then that. So then this guy is 1.055. Perfect. Okay, so now we need to go like that and like that. And then I want to bring this down 1.055. Perfect. So the top one is, not one that I want to mess with. Okay, so now we'll take this, copy that, paste it, and then put that to negative. Copy all that, paste it, and then to negative. And then again, copy all this, paste it, and go to negative. Okay, so those are all done. I'm actually gonna want to make one more of these, and we can go left, chrono back left, control shift C, control shift V. And then a 90 degree, and then we'll have to adjust here. And I'm forgetting that I want to be on this top one, not... Whoa. Okay, so now... can copy all this stuff. Duplicate this guy. Go like that. Go like that. And 90 and... whoops, negative 90. And then there we have it. So now we're done with the turn signals. Okay, so now these are actually going on these. So I want to copy all this stuff. Put it on that one. Ooh, yikes. Guess I don't. It's funny how, like, different things, they work way differently in how they go on. Okay, so now we'll take all that and copy it and go to here, but then we want that to be positive. And evidently it's got two of these for each side. Why, I have no idea. Okay, so that is all the light coronas. Now to script them all in. So light coronas, light corona. So it has 07. Okay. So then I want 012. Brake lights are 09. Oh, these are brake lights. That's why. Aha. So I definitely don't want those on the side. So then this is 014. Turn signals left is 0130. Whoops, not that one. And then this is the same, only that's a 1. Well, it's kind of the moment of truth now. We gotta go through here and remove some rigid bodies. Because if any of this stuff has rigid bodies on it, it is going to go completely wonky in game. And actually, I wonder now here. Let's see in the Seat Express. Lua, don't need that. Okay. See, did I put the cube map in here? Yes, I did, and I must have applied it already. Okay, what was I doing? Nothing in there. This I don't need. This I can close because it will save everything. Okay, and I don't need anything on that right now. So now we just gotta remove all these clip distances. And actually, I won't bore you guys with it. What I'm gonna do is remove all these clip distances, and then once I get in game, and then I'll do the store image and all that stuff, and then once I get in game, or we'll do the store image here on camera, I'll just finish off this wheel. I'll do the store stuff here quick, and then, so we go print screen to take a screenshot. We open up the store. And then I go left control V, keep canvas size, and then perfect. So saving that image. And then we need to rename this to just store. And then if I go here, oops, wrong thing. Misc things. Brand KFM. We'll go like that. So the reason I have this store image is it's just kind of something to run off of if I ever need to get a store image. So you can see we got the brand, the store, all that stuff. So I will be right back once I get in game. Okay, and now so now we need to buy a semi first. And I think we'll go with my favorite, the CAT CT660. Okay, so we'll save the game now. Just that way we got everything. Okay, now we need to go to Auger Wagons. There it is. So it's in game, that's the first part. It's being purchased. It's purchased. And it's in. I don't know why it's sinking like that. Oh, I forgot one rigid body. Okay. Well, that's not bad. That's the best that I've had so far. Oh, I think I messed something up on that trigger there. Whoa. Like, number one being, it's huge. What did I do? Okay, so I think I messed something up there. Okay, so I need to fix that. Okay, so, well, that's one of the best in-games that I've had so far. Where it actually in-gamed and I didn't have issues. Okay, so I missed a rigid body on one of the wheels. It was that one. There we go. That's the one that I missed. Okay, so now, holy crap. This is not going to be fun to fix. Rigid body, dynamic. Let's go static here. Are you going to let me change you? Yes, you are. Oh, it's going to change the entire thing, though. Okay, let's look at this Seat Express one here quick, though. Okay, so I am going to have to remake that. I'm pretty sure I made one. Dynamic compound and collision. Shape. Okay, so all my stuff is the same here. So I don't know why that's like that. And I also don't know why it got so huge. Good grief. So I don't need that. Old. Edited. Hoofta. That thing got way, 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 way too big. Yeah. Way too big. Holy. That only needs to be out to about there. Just enough to cover it. So what's poking through there? Oh, just that. Okay, so we can export that now. Export only the selected. Collision, that works. So now for the fun part. All of this stuff has to be cut from there, pasted into there. Yeah, and that's exactly what I figured was going to happen. I was hoping that would not happen. Okay. I don't want to delete that quite yet. Ah, everything wants to be ginormous. And I don't want it to be ginormous. Wait, I got an idea. Can I take this? This might be a good fix. Okay. So I have to make sure that I have everything back in the same order it was. Otherwise, I will be in some deep trouble here. Okay, let's just go like this here. Let's delete that. I'm just going to take a screenshot of this just because. Okay, so we're going to have to put this into paint. Just so that way I can make sure that I see everything. Oops, I probably just stopped. Good, I didn't. Okay, so that way I can see the order of everything over there. Okay. So now if we go static. Select something, come back. 0.8. Okay, let's try 0.5. Close. 4.5. Perfect. So now let's put that. Let's. No, not move down. Freeze the scale. Put that back on dynamic. Okay. Moment of truth. Sweet. That worked perfectly. Okay. So that can go there. This can get closed. That can get closed. And we'll replace that, and then I don't need that anymore. Okay, let's go find out here what's gonna happen. So this is definitely being a longer video than normal, but can't really do a whole ton in a half hour with these things, so. Time to find out what happens. I'm kind of really excited to finally have this thing done. That will be extremely nice to have it finished. Oh, I forgot to change. I still got to change all my textures to DDS format, but in due time. Okay, so let's look here. Any rigid bodies? No, it is sinking. I don't know why it's sinking, but it is. But let's hop into the truck. Okay, let's drive the truck to the yard here. And we will try resetting that. The farm is where we'll want to be with it anyways, so. Let me see, I hope my volume is turned down. Okay, let's reset this thing once. So it wants to sink that way. Unless those two tires are not indexed correct. Maybe that's what it is. We'll have to look at that. And my jacks are not scripted either. Okay, so we still got a little bit of work to do. But we're getting closer. Still don't know if it fills or not, but... Oh, I know another thing we can do. Let's check the turn signals. Okay, those all work. Brake lights working. Lights working. Cool. So we got our lights all work. We're good to go in that area. Okay, we'll just save again. Okay, so we need to look at some wheels here. We need to bring this up. Zero. Zero 01, zero 02, zero 03. So that's all correct there. Now we need to script in a jack, and the way that I'm going to do that is we're going to take my fuel trailer, copy some scripting off of that. Moving tool. I'm already there. So, we need to figure out where my jack is scripted here. Zero, 09, 07. So that is to the jack. So we need this stuff here. Those all go under the attacher joints. So that like that, and then the collision. Okay, so then the animation. Okay, so we have to play with that a little bit. Is there a script that I need? Nope. Okay, so we need 020 is the node for the jack. Oh, I didn't even look. Do I need something out of the mod desk? I don't believe that there was anything in the mod desk for that. No. Okay. So we can close that one as well. So then the move support. So this needs to be to that as well. So now we just set our start and finish times. So start. Okay, let's bring up my fuel trailer again. Just so I can remember which one needs to come first if it's... Okay, so up is start. Okay, so we need to put these in the up position first. So just need that. So that's 0. This is the number that we copied, and then this is 0. So then if I go back, so then it's just zeroed out for all the way down. 0 space 0 space 0. Okay, so now I can't figure out why that wheel is not working. Okay, let's just try. Where's my node stuff for those, though? Oh, because I think these are just... Okay, so yeah, let's just copy all this stuff once. We'll just try these tires here. Just because I don't know what else to try. So, actually, you know what? Hang on. Let's go like this. Let's just copy that line out. And then we'll go Control N. We'll just paste it all there. Then we'll copy this. Paste it there. Okay, let's try that once here. See if that works. Wait, cancel. I just want to save that. I don't want to close it right now. Oops, I don't want to include old. All right, let's see if this does anything. So I'm not worried about saving all the textures as a DDS right at this second. Those aren't that big of a deal. And I'm not going to worry about doing them on camera because it's pretty easy. You just open it in paint.net, Control-Shift-S, select DDS, and there you go. And then once you're done, you just delete all the PNG ones. So pretty easy. Pretty boring, that's for sure. Okay, so it's still sitting really, really weird. I don't know what the deal is with that. Can we at least pull it now? We can. It is sitting goofily. So yeah, there's something with the tire that's... let's try and buying a telehandler here once. Telehandler and some pallet forks. Just see if maybe it just is underground and doesn't want to come back or what. And it maybe just needs a little push. A little bit of a helping hand here. That's not going to work there. Try shooting that out a little bit too and helping. Yeah, there's no budging that thing. Holy smokes. Guess we'll just try and deal with it here. I'll have to see if I can fix that somehow, but let's just see if we can fill this thing and unload it. I'm not getting a refill here. Uh-oh. Come on, cat. You got a big enough engine. Let's do this. I'm not getting a fill. So that's not good. And what the crap happened to my driver? He is all kinds of twisted there. Okay, well, let's go over to Seeds once and see if we can fill from there. I may have it put into the mod desk wrong or something, maybe. I'll have to talk to LMB Farmer and see if he can help me figure out this odd issue. Come on, pull, pull, pull. Oh boy. Not good. But hey, it's in game. And we're about to find out if it actually works or not. So it's basically just dropping until that hits. So I'll have to send LMB a message here after I'm done, see if he can help me figure that out. Yeah, and it does not want to refill. Not sure, but the rest of it I'll figure out later on. Like I said, I'll message LMB here and see if he can help me. Maybe he can help me figure out these few issues I'm having. But otherwise, it's in game. It's for the most part working. So that is pretty good. I'm happy with that. Yeah, so that'll do it for this video. Next week, maybe we'll be working on a different model, something else, so we will see. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Make sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to my social medias, my mod site, as well as other cool YouTube channels that we're taking a look at. My PC specs and upload schedule are also listed down there. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.